Namaste viewers, Hare Krishna. Welcome to MK Chastravastu once again. We are back with our Navagraha series, the basic Graha series. So after last time, myself along with Hiral Parikh ji, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Manjunath ji. Welcome everyone. And it is after a little long break that we are back to our series after completing all our important appointments and everything. So we are back here with the Jupiter video.
That's what Hiral ji, it's like a blessings for us as we are initiating with Jupiter today. So as per Graha series only, Jupiter is all about the new blessings and new things to begin up. Let us not late the topic. Myself here, Jyotisha Vastu Acharya Manjunath, and along with Hiral ji, we are discussing about the planet Jupiter, God Brihaspati and Graha Brihaspati. All of these things today. Let us share my screen for our viewers. So as we are seeing, Hiral ji, today it is like Guru. In English name, it is like Jupiter. It is a most of a sattva planets. Guru means it is a split word. It is an inner spirit of our own self. Means we have to make inner awareness. So likewise, there is no any like knowledge outside this world, because as we know, like yata brahmande tata pindande, means whatever exists in the universe, all the things exist within us. So the things, the realization is important of those things. Those realization is comes through the planet Guru. So this becomes very in this universe, it is a very important planet. So this is for our viewers the image of Lord Guru. And the different names of Brihaspati. Brihaspati is the teacher of gods, and Jupiter, as I told you, told the viewers, like the different names of Jupiter are Guru, Arya, Angirasuna, Brihaspati, Devapati, Daivagna, Vijaya, Indra Purohita, Suryacharya, Sureshtha, Vajaspati, Vachasmapati. So these all the things are the different names of Guru. So this is the thing, because Guru, entire Guru is called as the Brihaspati, means something with related to the big object in this universe. Means entire things are involved within this the planet. Now let us see through the image what is the Jupiter. So slowly we are explaining our viewers with respect to astrological point of view, the image explanation which viewers are seeing in the screen. So as I told, in Sanskrit term, Guru is called as Brihaspati, meaning Spati means of Spati of Briha, means the spirit of vastness of the universe written as Brihaspati. It is an Indian name and refers to different mythological figures depending on the age of the text. So in ancient Hindu literature, Brihaspati is an Vedic era sage who counsels the god, which in some medieval texts, the word refers to the largest planet of the solar system, that is Jupiter.
Yes.
So he taught the Bhishma the duties of a king, and whichever he later taught to the Vidura also. So we can refer it as some of this important sage also, because it is called as Daiva Guru, means he is a guru to the Lord also, and who all the common people also. Because as in the starting of a program, I have quoted the Lord Guru as a inner awareness within us. So let us see what is the sage concept of the Brihaspati. Sage or Rishi, whatever the things. So Brihaspati, yes, appears in the Rig Veda, that is pre-1000 BC only, such as in the dedications to him in the hymn of 50 book number 4. People can refer it in as per the Rig Veda. So he is described as a sage born from the first great light, the one who drew away the darkness within our soul. So the Brihaspati is bright and the pure, and carries special bow whose string has Ratha or the cosmic order, basis of the Dharma.
Okay.
And this Brihaspati has immense the knowledge, and character is revered, and he is considered as the guru, that is a teacher, by all the devas. So So referring to this Brihaspati in the Vedic literature and other ancient texts, sage Brihaspati is also called as by the other names which we have quoted in the early, like whatever the different names. And Brihaspati wives, his wives are the Shubhatrayi and Tara Devi.
Yes.
Means these are the goddesses who personifies the stars in the sky.
Yes.
And the reverence for the sage Brihaspati endured through the medieval period, and one of the many Dharma Shastras was named after the Lord Brihaspati.
Okay.
While we are referring to the many manuscripts, likewise the manuscript of Brihaspati is Smriti, that is called Brihaspati Smriti, including the Brihaspati. So have not survived in the modern era, its verses were cited in the other Indian texts. So scholars have made an effort to extract these cited verses to understand to the layman, thus creating the modern reconstruction of the Brihaspati Smriti. So, like this, the Jali and Ayanagar have gathered some of the 2400 verses of the last Brihaspati Smriti, means which has been lost. So, they extracted in a text manner. So, finally, the Brihaspati Smriti was likely larger and more comprehensive text than the Manusmriti. And available evidences suggest that the discussion of the judicial process and Brihaspati Smriti was often cited. So after this extraction, the main God's Brihaspati's definition has taught to the spiritual world or astrological world. So in a lighter words for astrological world, from extracting from those texts as per Rig Veda, which I have mentioned, the Lord of the sacred speech and teachers of the God Brihaspati is a son of Angirasa and Surupa Devi. And he is the teacher, highest priest, means like Purohita, which worships the Lord. He is the Sattva Guna, represents the knowledge and the teaching. And his speciality is he know all the Vedas and is expert in all the forms of mantras and knowledge. So hence this Jupiter is called as the divine teacher. And generally, as per the mythology, is a husband of Tara Devi, literally meaning all star, and is father of a Mercury, means it's like stepfather concept, which for our viewers they can go through the Mercury lesson where we have explained clearly.
Yes.
And as I told, the Brihaspati is also author of Smritis, ancient scriptures of the country, which are said to be divine in the original, but were recorded for the benefit of the humanity to understand the normal things. So this is all, and Brihaspati is one of the major god to extract the moksha concept also, because moksha is also awareness. So many more things over the Jupiter. So one by one things we have explained with the image concept. So any more things to add on this point, Hiralji, apart from your side?
Yes, I would like to just share my screen and explain it to our viewers. Okay, can you see my screen?
Yeah, it's visible.
So first of all, we will start with the prayer, which is being taught to us when we are just a child. That is Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha. This is the shloka which is taught to all of us when we are young, and it simply means that Guru is the representative of Lord Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh. He is the one who sustains all the knowledge and destroys the seeds of ignorance. I salute to such Guru. Now, Jupiter, in the form of a Guru, is a priest. He is a spiritual guide. Whereas in the form of Brihaspati, he is a strategist. So Guru, that is Jupiter, it has two forms. One is in the form of Guru and the other is in the form of Brihaspati, which is a strategist. Now, why a strategist? People will think like that. The reason is that imagine if you are planning to start with a business, investing a huge amount in it. Of course, you will take the opinion of your chartered accountant before jumping into anything unknown and be sure of taking the right step. Whereas you will seek the blessings of your family guru. As you said correctly, that guru is the light and the spirit. So he is a guiding light to you. So in older days, kings used to seek advice from their astrologer to make sure they are taking the right steps at the right time. So this is the role of a guru. Now I will explain it with the example. In Mahabharata, Guru Kripacharya was the Kul Guru. That is, he was a priest to the Kauravs and he guided them on the basis of Vedas, Shastras, everything. So it was bringing awareness to their soul. Whereas Guru Dronacharya acted as a Brihaspati, teaching all the Kauravas various war skills and participated as a strategist in the Mahabharata war. This is the difference between Guru and a Brihaspati. I hope it is clear to all the viewers. Now we will talk about the expansion of Jupiter. We all know that Jupiter is the biggest planet in the solar system. It is abundance. It is the karka of family, wealth, work, gains, and all auspicious aspects in our life. Everyone wants their family, wealth, work, gains to get expanded day by day. This justifies the nature of Jupiter, that is expansion. This nature is connected with the Vaman avatar of Lord Vishnu, where he came as a small Brahmin boy to King Bali and demanded 3 steps of land. So once the king agreed to this, he expanded himself, taking the earth and the space in the first 2 steps. This destroyed King Bali's ego and he offered his head for the 3rd step. Lord Vamana graced King Bali because of this gesture and made him the king of Patal Loka. What this episode tells us is that Jupiter is expansion. Anything which expands is Jupiter. We all want that everything related to our money, wealth, then family, everything should get expanded. So this is properly explained by the Vaman avatar. Vaman avatar was the avatar of Lord Vishnu, but he represents Jupiter correctly. And a very intelligent person is defined by Jupiter. Now, when Jupiter is present in the 1st, 5th, or 9th houses, it expands a person's body because it directly aspects the ascendant. Either it is sitting in the ascendant or it is aspecting the ascendant by its 5th or the 9th aspect. So it may lead to an overweight person or a person who is an obese. Now, previously, all the food was prepared in pure ghee. Pure ghee is the clarified butter. And pure ghee is a symbol of knowledge. This is the reason that ghee is used to prepare the sweets and the naivedya. Naivedya is something which is offered to the god. So when we consume it in the form of prasad, prasad is called to the food which has already been offered to the god. And when we consume it, we acquire knowledge. We all say that we should never waste the prasad. We should always consume it, whether it is in this much quantity also. We should not neglect it, which we should always have. The reason behind it is that it is prepared in pure ghee, and ghee is a symbol of knowledge. So we should not forget that Jupiter is ghee also, and we should consume it. Also understand that Jupiter is the jiva present in any and every living organism of the world. Jiva is the actual DNA. It is so related to biology. So it is the DNA which is passed from one to the other generation. The placement of Jupiter helps us to determine the luck of a native in begetting the children, family, wealth, and prosperity. imagine if a person's Jupiter is either debilitated or very badly damaged in his chart, or is aspected by a weak or a very malefic planets and everything, then he or she will surely get some problems in determining their luck, in the favors which is obtained from the nature and everything, in begetting the children, family, wealth, prosperity. He will surely suffer. Now I would like to explain guru traits and the concept of Dakshina. Jupiter is the ruler of Sagittarius. It is a fiery sign, and fire is always pure. A real guru will destroy your ego and will set you on a righteous path. He is a disciplinarian who will test you at every step, make you slog before giving any knowledge. He will never tolerate any nonsense from you and will straight away curse you. So a real guru is a guru who will destroy your ego. Always remind yourself all those things. When you feel that even in school days or in college days, maybe somebody must have scolded you while doing a wrong thing or anything. But always keep it in mind that he is the real guru who always tries to teach you some or the other way. Now, Rishi Durvasa was known for giving curses who didn't obey or respect him. However, a real guru's curse also turns into blessing. Always remember, his curse will also turn into blessing. And we can see it from our epics or any literature, our past literature, where Rishi Durvasa had given some curses to people. But then it becomes a blessing for the person who was cursed by him. We can also say that in charts where Jupiter turns out to be functional malefic, he might not give you fruitful results, but will try and not to harm you. So this is the grace of Jupiter, that even if he can't help you, even if he can't give you fruits, but he will not try to harm you. One should always keep these things in mind. A person having a strong Jupiter will be in charge of everything and will get angry very fast who doesn't obey him. But one should never disrespect a guru. God himself obeys his guru and washes his feet while on earth. The best example is of Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna was a student of Sandipani Muni. And as Guru Dakshina, he restored his guru's child who was abducted by a demon known as the Sankhasura. Knowledge acquired without giving Guru Dakshina doesn't fructify. Eklavya had to offer his thumb as a Guru Dakshina to Dronacharya for acquiring knowledge of archery behind the trees without his permission. Even Karna was cursed by Guru Parshuram to forget all the knowledge at the day he needed it the most for hiding the truth of being a Kshatriya from his Guru. So we should always remember this, that even if you want to acquire knowledge, you don't have money, you gather money and then you acquire knowledge. Without paying Guru Dakshina, whatever knowledge is gained will be never useful for you. It will always lead you into some or the other problems. So one should always keep in mind, there are certain group of people, who does like this, that they will acquire the knowledge, they will have all the things, and then they will just spread it out to their friends, family, whatever. And those people do acquire knowledge. I don't say they can't acquire knowledge. They will acquire, but they won't be able to use it. Maybe it won't fructify them in their life. So always remember such things. Now I would like to talk about the houses of Jupiter. Now Jupiter rules the 9th sign of Sagittarius and the 12th sign of Pisces in the Kalpurush Kundli. All the basic people must be knowing this thing. It rules our luck with the 9th house, religion, long distance travel, then higher education, father, guru, publishing. Everything is represented by ninth house. So all these houses are ruled by Jupiter. The spiritual awakening, ashrams, foreign lands, or the other world, exit from the world, is the 12th house. That is the Pisces sign. In the earlier days, students traveled a long way to the Gurukul to gain higher knowledge. In the earlier days, Gurukul was like a non-profit organization where selected students could stay and study our ancient scriptures, Vedas, and acquire all the knowledge. Now, what we are supposed to look at is that the ninth house is connected to the gurus and the higher education. And the 12th house is the non-profit organizations. See, both the houses are ruled by guru itself. And both the houses are very important for acquiring knowledge. Because in the earlier days, nowadays also, see, people are not going to ashrams. But where they are going to foreign lands. Foreign lands again is the 12th house. And they are acquiring knowledge over there in isolation and everything. So this is the thing which is associated to the houses of Jupiter. Now I would like to elaborate the 12th house. 12th house is sleep and exit from this world. Now, how do we feel when we die? We feel like having a deep sleep for a longer period of time, which is known as a Chir Nindra in Sanskrit and in Hindi. Jupiter's domain year expands the sleep to a longer period, maintaining its auspiciousness. It is believed that at the time of death, if the transit Jupiter is placed in the 12th house or aspects the 12th house, then the person reaches a better place than he is on this earth. This is the Jupiter's power. This is what you said. It is the sattvic nature of Jupiter. That if it is present or if it is transiting or if it is aspecting the 12th house, then the person will be at a better place than he is on this earth. And I have studied this from a very, very nice teacher. And he was very kind enough to teach me this. So always remember that whenever you can, if you have the timing of your any relative or friends who had passed by, if you have that time, then look at the transit, whether Jupiter was transiting through the 12th house or was it aspecting the 12th house, you will get your answer. Now we will talk about the professions related to Jupiter. Finance, economics, MBA, manager, banking profession, philosopher, professor, anything related to biology, whether it's botany, zoology, or cooking, any form of management. Management, why? Because guru is the one who manages a lot of things. Guru is the one who is important for every child. And every child should get equal right. So it is related to law also. Insurance agents, anything related to people that profession comes under Jupiter. Then microbiologist, chemist, analyst, any publisher, film director, why? Because it is related to publishing and everything. Astrologer, Brahmin who does Havan, vegetable or the fruit vendor, grocery shop, anything related to the things needed by the people comes under the domain of Jupiter. Now, in our body, Jupiter represents the liver, fat, gallbladder, then circulation of blood in the veins, in the heart, in our body, thighs, feet, right ear. I have seen many times, even you must have observed, after the age of 60, many people turn to be deaf. Or at least there is some problem in their listening power. Yeah. So that happens because at that time, whatever dasha they are going, it's fine. But they are into the Padam Chakra of Jupiter. And if Jupiter is afflicted in their chart, they will have more hearing issues. Yeah. So always remember that. When afflicted, it gives problems related to these body parts, whatever I described. And it makes a native extremist, having extravagant ideas. He can be careless, over optimistic. That is the biggest problem with people with a very strong Jupiter. They are very over optimistic. Even if someone comes and takes away their things or steals anything from their house or purse, they are still optimistic. No, no, it's okay. Everything will be fine. False hopes, loss by relying on others, poor. They can be poor also. Many times we see that a person has immense knowledge, but he is not rich. That this is the reason behind it. And because they are very good, na? They will help all the people, but they won't think about themselves. They will think that God will take care of me. And so they will not, it doesn't mean they don't want to strive hard, but they are more interested in gaining knowledge and imparting knowledge. Now, there is a remedy which I would like to share with everyone. It's a very simple remedy. If you feel that your Jupiter is ill-placed in your chart, then you can do this remedy. So Jupiter remedies involve offering yellow flowers to any guru, reciting guru mantra, praying to Lord Ganesh or Dattatreya. This is to be done on every Thursday. And you can also prepare a laddu with a jaggery and turmeric and Bengal gram and feed it to the cows on every Wednesday, on every Thursday. So this is a very good remedy which anyone can do if there is any problem related to the body parts which I described, or having any issues related to their professions, if they are into these professions and they are not gaining enough of their fruits, then they can definitely go for such remedies. So that's all from my side. I will stop sharing my screen, and I hope you gained little knowledge from my side, and even everyone else will get benefited from this. I've tried from my side to explain whatever I could.
Yes, thank you, Hiral ji, for our viewers explaining in detail. Let us see the basic information. The Jupiter ruled is a Thursday, and direction as per Vastu, it is in northeast direction and yellow color. 13 month approximate for an orbit, and 12 years an average. Nature is knowledge and wisdom. Constellations means nakshatras ruled by Punarvasu, Vishakha and Purvakadra. These are the friendly planets, Sun, Moon, Mars and many are Mercury, Venus. Neutral are Saturn and Rahu, and the own signs, as you rightly so told, like Sagittarius and Pisces, that is in the Dhanus Rashi and Meena Rashi. Mula Trikona is of a Dhanus Rashi only and exalted in the Cancer sign, and it is a debilitated in the Capricorn. The special features, as you know, it's a knowledge, wisdom, all those things. Metal is gold. Precious stone is Pukraj, that is yellow sapphire. And Dasha period comes with as the 16 years. So if it is well placed, it gives wisdom, education, and property, prosperity. And if it is adversely placed, some sort of arrogance will be there. So representation of a teacher, elder people, and as body parts you have explained, and diseases are a jaundice, inflammation, cough, syrup, and ear problems. So this is all up to the guru. As guru is for predictive astrology, we know for our viewers might be knowing the basic knowledge. It involves, it's a karaka for the important houses 1, 5, 9, 7. All the growth giving houses means people want expansion regarding those houses. So one word to end the topic for guru, it is a growth. So this is all up to guru. And keep stay tuned with our channel for more updates. In next episode, we can explain it in the answer. Thank you, viewers, for watching this video completely. Stay tuned for MK Chashto Vastu for more videos. Namaste.
Namaste.